we're gonna start today's lesson. We're gonna do a fun activity, but first we're gonna start by doing kind of a winter Christmassy story, okay? But I'll let three kids be on the beanbags. Oh, I think I'm just gonna hold them so then it's ready though. Okay, Aviana, you get the black one. Mallory and Grayson. Okay, but we remember the rules, right? So the only one sitting on them. And then everyone else, you guys can find seats. Well, I'll hold it so you can see it, okay? All right, here we go. Okay. Ho-hum, yawned Mr. Tortoise. Winter is here. So it is, yawned Mrs. Tortoise. Come on, Shelly, time for bed. But I don't feel sleepy yet, said Shelly. Does everybody know what a tortoise is?
Yeah.
Kendall, what's a tortoise? A turtle, but it's usually bigger, right?
And it doesn't go in water.
There you go. And it looks like they're getting ready to go to sleep. Ridiculous, cried Mr. Tortoise. All tortoises go to sleep for the winter. Why? Asked Shelly. Because it's cold outside and there's no food. But I don't want to go to sleep, said Shelly. I want to see what winter is like. Ridiculous, cried Mr. and Mrs. Tortoise together. Who ever heard of a tortoise outside in winter?
I have.
Can someone with a quiet name or quiet hand tell me what you think ridiculous means? It's kind of a big word. Cooper.
It means like what?
Yeah, kind of like Mallory.
Ridiculous means it's
funny? Crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Silly. It can mean a little different things depending on what you're talking about. But I think when they use it, they're saying, "Oh, well, that's crazy. What turtle goes out in winter? It's too cold."
Yeah.
Soon, Mr. Tortoise began to snore, and not long after that, Mrs. Tortoise began to snore, and not long after that, Shelly left her warm bed of leaves, and out she went through a hole in the shed to see what winter was like. Do you think this is a good idea?
No.
Oh, man.
No.
Outside the shed, Shelly blinked. There was snow and ice everywhere, even on the duck pond and the hill. As she lumbered along, a duck spotted her. A tortoise out in winter, quacked the duck. Ridiculous. No, it isn't, said Shelly. Oh, no? Then let's see you break through the ice to get food like I can. Ha, quack, ha. He's right, thought Shelly. I can't do that. I don't have a beak. That would be kind of hard for the tortoise to get food, right? Especially if it's under the ice. Yes.
That's kind of mean.
It is kind of mean. That's not very nice, huh? As Shelly began to walk up the hill, she met a dog. A tortoise out in winter, barked the dog. Ridiculous. No, it isn't, said Shelly, feeling a little cross. Oh, no? Then let's see you keep warm by running around like I can. Ha, woof, ha. He's right, thought Shelly sadly. I can't do that either. Do tortoises move very fast?
No.
And the faster we go, the warmer we get, right? So do you think a tortoise is going to get very warm?
No.
Probably not. How's
it go?
It's up here. The dog ran off after a cat, but the cat climbed up a tree. She looked down at Shelly. A tortoise out in winter? Meowed the cat. Ridiculous. No, it isn't, said Shelly, even more crossly. Oh, no? Then let's see you run into a nice warm house as quickly as I can. Ha, meow, ha. She's right, thought Shelly, shivering with cold. I can't run like a dog or a cat. I'm just too slow. Yeah, it doesn't sound like these animals are being very nice to the tortoise, right? Okay, ready? The cat raced off into her house before the dog could catch her, and Shelly trudged toward the top of the hill where she met a bird. A tortoise out in winter? Cheat the bird? Ridiculous! No, it isn't, snapped Shelly. Oh, no? Then let's see you fly home and cuddle up with your family like I can. Ha, cheap, ha. Of course I can't fly, thought Shelly. I can't even hop. Oh, man. Shelly felt cold and miserable. She remembered her warm, cozy bed, and a tear trickled down her cheek. They're all right, she thought. A tortoise out in winter is ridiculous. She was so sad she didn't notice the big patch of ice ahead, and she slipped on it. Shelly fell over backward and began to slide down the hill. Faster and faster she went. It's kind of like a sled, huh?
Yeah.
It's going real fast.
He can finally do something.
There you go. Faster than a dog could run. Faster than a cat. Until suddenly she hit a bump and flew into the air like a bird.
See,
a tortoise flying? I've never seen that before.
Me neither.
I have.
Okay, ready? Whee! With a thump, Shelly landed on the icy duck pond and slid toward the hole in the shed. But it was all covered up with ice. Ha, quack, ha, what did I say? Cried the duck as she slid by him. Where's your beak to break the ice with? I don't have a beak, thought Shelly, but I do have
a shell.
Oh, you guys are smart. A shell! And tucking her head inside it, she broke through the ice into the shed and home.
See, that was funny.
All the noise, Mrs. Tortoise woke up. You haven't been outside, have you, Shelly? She asked. A tortoise out in winter, she said, Shelly, snuggling into bed. And before she could say, ridiculous, she was fast asleep. So she kind of had a fun snow day, right?
Yeah.
It's like, what would a tortoise do in the snow for a day? She did a lot of things. Well, you saw what she did.
But she could make a snow tortoise.
Okay, so everybody find their seats, and I will tell you what we're going to be doing.
A snow tortoise.
For a day. Our topic is going to be, what if we were stuck in a snow globe for a day?
That's the part of our...
That would be so fun. Look. Look what we're going to make.
Ah.
Do you see the snow? It kind of moves around in the snow globe. So we know Mrs. Robertson isn't a very good drawer, but there's me stuck in the snow globe. And what do you think I did in the snow globe?
I made a snowman.
I built a snowman. And then I wrote about it. So you guys are going to be making your snow globe, and you're going to draw yourselves stuck in it. But before we do that, we have to think about what we would do in a snow globe for a day. All sorts of things. So what is the first thing that needs to go?
Name number!
Yes, sir. You want to pass them out? Okay. You can hand the rest. Right there. Yes.
And date.
Oh, and date. Yeah, you can put the date, but really, I just need to know your name on there so I know whose is whose. Okay. Perfect. So, you see that little box? Let's see.
I'm writing my name on it.
make sure everyone's names on it. We gotta wait for the TV to turn on for a second so you can see how I did mine.
That was Carter's.
I like this.
Thank you. Okay, do you see that up there? Now we're gonna write in pencil. I did it in Christmas color just so you guys could really see it. But voices up in 5. Do you know what that says? Can someone read that for me? Caleb, what does that say?
Hear.
So, let's come up with a list of things that we might hear if we were in a snow globe. With a quiet hand, what are some things? Harrison.
We might hear, when we shake it, we might hear all the shaking noise.
So shaking? So, or just like a loud noise?
Yeah.
Loud noise, okay. Loud noise. What else, Savannah?
We might feel the breeze.
The breeze. Okay. Mallory.
You might see it shape.
You might see it. So we're looking for things that we hear. What do we hear? You know, what I wrote was I might hear laughter. Like kids laughing or someone could be laughing on the outside, having fun. Because you hear that. Or music. Do we hear Christmas music?
Yeah.
Around wintertime? So those are things. So I wrote laughter and I wrote music. So I need you to write at least 2 things that you might hear in if you were stuck in a snow globe. So we have loud noise, we have breeze. I also have laughter and music. Anything else that you might hear? Kendall.
Footsteps.
Footsteps. Yeah. Like in the snow?
We might see some too.
Ooh, we'll get to that. Okay, so I need to see writing. Let's try to write some things. So. Thank you. Perfect. And then eyes up here when we are ready to go to the next box. I'm going to have someone read that next box for me. Oh, you guys are quick. Okay, Quinn, can you tell me what that next box says on your paper?
Feel.
Feel. What do you think we might feel if we were in a snow globe? John.
The cold ice on the side.
So you might feel cold?
No, the cold ice that's on the side of the
snow. Oh, if you were touching it? Okay. Okay. Cold ice. So if I write something that you think you might feel, so start writing it down. What else, Mallory?
If you feel the snow.
Snow. Let's see. Oh, yeah. What would you feel? Your gloves, so you might have gloves on, right? Okay. Globe is small, so maybe I'll feel warm in my snow globe. I might feel excited because I'm building a snowman or I'm having fun. And I'm happy in my snow globe. If I was stuck in a snow globe, I'd be happy. It'd be kind of fun. So you can write, would you be happy? Would you be cold? Would you be warm? What are some things that you would feel? So you write that. Yes, Alicia.
I'm already done.
You're ready for the next one. Okay, we'll move on to the middle one. So you can finish up writing if you're still, but we'll go ahead. Carter, what does that say?
See.
If you were stuck in a snow globe for a day, what would you see? Person.
Ice,
lots of ice. Okay, I'll see. Okay, I'm gonna erase this one, okay? We good? So you might see, did you say ice?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Ice. What else? Sienna. What was that? Yes. What else could you see? Yes.
A bed.
A bed.
You might see a bet?
Yeah,
okay.
We might be in a tribune room.
Oh, there you go. So in a snow globe, do you have to be outside in a snow globe?
No.
Could you be in a cute little Christmas house?
Yeah.
Or something? Yeah, so you might be in like in a room? Okay, what else? Anyone else? Kendall.
Couches?
What?
Couches, like if you're in the living room.
In the living room. So we'll put it in the house. How about that? So right now on our web, we're just writing words. We don't have to worry about sentences yet because we're just throwing out our ideas so that when we go to write our sentences, we know what we want to write about, right? Does everyone understand?
Santa?
We're moving on. We're moving on to the next box. Someone want to tell me what that word says on that side? Who has an hedge? Shanna.
Taste.
It does say taste. What do you think you would taste if you were in a snow globe? This could be kind of tricky. Gunner.
Snow.
Yes. I think you could taste now. Hey, what else might you taste?
Alicia.
Ice.
So ice and snow are kind of the same thing, but we'll just do that. There you go, ice. What else? Do you have to be just tasting snow, or could you be eating other things? Mallory.
Snowflakes.
So we'll keep it with the snow. We have ice. Savannah.
Icicles.
So let's see. So what I wrote, so you kind of have an idea. I wrote snow, just like you guys said. I wrote hot cocoa. I think I'd be drinking hot cocoa in the snow globe. And candy canes. Do you see a lot of those around Christmas time? Okay, so what else might you taste? I need some more ideas.
No.
Candy canes. So I have it right up there, but I'll write it again. What else? Kayla.
Ice cream.
Ooh, because it's cold.
Snow ice cream.
Okay, what else? What are there any things that you like to eat around the holiday time?
Yes.
Cookies.
Ooh, yum. Cookies. I like cookies. Perfect. So make sure you're writing at least two things that you might taste in the taste box on your web. And then we have the last one for the web. What does that say? What does that say? Cooper, can you tell me what that last word says on your paper?
Smell.
What? Man, this is tough. What do you think you would smell in a snow globe? Carter.
Hot dogs. Like in a house. Like
someone's
making it.
So you might smell hot chocolate. You can smell that. Okay, what else? Let's see, Sienna. Peppermint. So that's what I wrote, but yes, peppermint. Because it seems like there's a lot of peppermint candies and stuff around Christmas time. There is candy canes. What else? So I wrote a campfire, but kind of just like a fire. Does any of your, raise your hand if your moms or dad turn on a fire during the winter time to keep warm. It's nice, huh? So you might smell that. Anything else?
Can you write that fire?
So it says fire. Yes, I'll write fire. There you go, right there. What else might you smell? Cooper.
I'm done.
Oh, you're done. Perfect, you got your ideas. Harrison.
You would smell.
What's that?
You would smell noodles.
You would smell what?
noodles in case you were in the house.
So food? Because you can smell all sorts of food, right? Write food so that if other people smell that too, they can write it. Food. Kayla.
Carrot because there's so many a carrot for you.
Mmm, yep. Okay, so once you have your web, you've written at least two things in each square. That's gonna help you with your writing. So the next part of this project is we have to draw our picture, right? We have to draw something in the snow globe. So what has to be in the snow globe when you're drawing, Harrison?
You.
You. Because it says, the day I was stuck in a snow globe. If you're not in there, would that make sense?
No.
Maybe no.
It could be a snowman.
But do you have to draw a snowman?
No.
No. You could draw whatever might be happening in your snow globe. And then after, I'll put some snow in it so that it looks like a snow globe.
But it's not.
Mallory.
Could you put candy cane up there?
Yes. So candy cane.
Candy canes.
It's right up there.
You already read it. Why do you have like a little snowman that's built out of like paper, but we're gonna draw one?
Because I wanted to make sure you could see it from up here. Sometimes I have to do things, I had to draw in pen so that you could see it. But I want you to draw. That's why you have lots of crayons to use. Oh, yes. But so then I want you to draw with crayons, okay? Yes. No, you're right. Miss Price. It's okay. If you love candy canes, that's good. Okay, so I'm gonna pass out. John, do you wanna help me?
And give me a number first.
So on the back, real quick, write the name on the back of the paper. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead and press.
So some of you will get blue paper, some of you will get gray paper. They're all the same.